everybody, it's Karen here from tuppencecolour.co.uk. Thank you very much for joining me today. And who remembers this project? I started this mini album back in the summer, and for various reasons I didn't get it finished. There was some personal stuff going on in my life. We had a bereavement, and then there was the new Stamping Up holiday catalogue made available to demonstrators, so that kind of distracted me. I went off and played with a lot of the lovely things that were in there. I had to order more tranquil textures paper. It took a while to come, and yes, I am making excuses. This has been sitting on my shelf of UFOs, that's unfinished objects, for some time, and somebody got in touch with me through Facebook and said, you know, are you ever going to finish that, because I was kind of enjoying it. So this is for you, and I will put your name below. Thank you very much for nudging me. I am going to finish it. There isn't much left to do, so let's have a quick recap of what we've done so far, and then we'll crack on. So this is now looking pretty darn full. Okay, there isn't a lot more room left in here, so I have this page, which kind of opens up and opens up like that. That's my first page, and in between each page we have a pocket where we can put little file folders and things like that. Okay, and on this first one I've gone ahead and I've made the file folders, and I've put some photographs in and some space for journaling. I haven't done that on the other pages because it was taking up a bit of time, and you know, they're my family photos and you don't really want to see them, do you? So again, this page has got little slots for little file cards to go in, that you can put, again, you can have a picture in there and space for journaling. That one's a picture of the lifeboat. And then there was this one, which is a waterfall type of page. And then, as you can see, it's getting really full. This one closes with a magnet, and there's loads and loads and loads of space for pictures, for journaling, for cards. You know, you can do whatever you like with it. Okay, so this next one, this is a hidden slider. So if I pull on the bottom of the page there. Come on, there we go. My two panels pop out, and I've got room for pictures and for journaling. I just want to tuck my seashell back in there. This one is just a plain facing, because what's happening now, I'm running out of space in between pages of the project, so it's actually getting quite difficult to open the pages in the book, because it's absolutely stuffed full of real estate of where you can put your, you know, you can put your scrapbooking and your journaling. This one was a slider sliding open. So open it like that. And again, space in here. And this is where I ran out of paper and I had to stop. So as you can see, I did go back and I did cover up all of those bits of card for journaling. So I think that kind of was where I left it. So since I did that page, I've created this page, which again is one that has got a few flaps. It's got a little pocket. But on this side, actually, I've just covered the envelope, and there are no flaps. There's nothing fancy with this one at all. That is just a straight page to mount a picture or to do some journaling. And there's the usual space in there to put tags or whatever you want to. And that is because I am running out of space. So what I'm going to do for this page, I'm going to kind of reproduce this page, so with the flaps, all right, and all the all the rest of it going on there. So it'll be a pocket, it'll be a pocket and some flaps that open up. And then on the last page, then that will have something on there. And what I'm thinking of doing is have that open out into a full piece of 12 by 12. So I am going to crack on and we'll see how far we get. I may not finish it in this video, but if not, we will definitely finish it soon. And if you want to see the story so far, there is a playlist. Okay, go and have a look at that, because I've put every video in this series into a single playlist. Okay, so I've talked enough. Let us crack on with making the pages. This is Mary Merlot. It's 4¾ by 7¼, and I'm going to score on three sides at 1/2 inch. Move my scoreboard out of the way, and I'm going to cut away those two corners where the folds are, and I'm just going to just train the folds with my fingers for now. Let me bring in my album and going to measure it against my envelope here. Oh. Glued itself down, it's been sitting for too long. I have neglected this project. Naughty, naughty girl. Book is now getting very, very full. That's looking pretty good. So let's go ahead and just stick this flap in. I'm not going to stick two end flaps down for the time being. I'm just going to pop this into place on there, just like that. Make sure that I'm covered. See, I haven't got cut that quite long enough. Never mind, we will fix it. Won't be a problem. Okay, because we're going to take this piece, which is what? It's about 2½ inches, and we're going to make that into a pocket that fits along there. Okay, you with me so far? Excellent. Again, I should probably have given that about an extra 1/8 of an inch. But not to worry, because we'll make this pocket that's going to fit along. Go over there, and that is going to go over there. Okay, so this is now a little bit short at the bottom, but just a little bit short here, so I'm just putting another score line just outside the first one, just about 1/8 of an inch, and I will have a shorter flap, but it will fit around the envelope a bit better. Okay, and let's have a look at this side as well. Does that need the same thing? Oh, that one's all right. Okay, and as you can see, It's a little bit short along the edge there. Don't know what went wrong with my cutting. That's not going to be a problem because I've got a strip of paper here that is about 2.5 inches wide. And what I will do, I will stick that onto the bottom to make a little pocket. So I'm going to go and do that now. And I'm going to finish gluing these strips down. Alright, so I'm going to leave that sitting there. And I have one of my pieces of DSP. And I'm going to cut a piece off that. So this was what, 2.5 inches wide. So if I cut a piece 2¼, okay. And yeah, this is all a bit ad hoc today. So that should go along there just like that. I really do want to get this album finished now. It's been far too long. Far, far too long. And more by luck than judgment, I've even managed to line up the pattern on the paper, so that's pretty good. So I have a pocket on this side, and on this side we shall have a flap. So this piece is 4¼ by 7, and I've... So this is a piece of the Merry... 3, 2, 1. So this is Merry Merlot, and it is 4¼ by 7, and I've scored and folded it at 1/2 inch. And as you can see, I've gone ahead and applied some paper DSP to one side. And I'm just going to glue that into place over here. I'm not too worried about the flap showing because I'm going to cover that in just a moment. Okay, just popping that into place. And now I have another piece of the same DSP. And that is going to cover... pocket, and I have flaps. Let me put that one in to pull it. All right, so this page now has a flap where I can put tags or photographs. And it's got a flap here that opens out, so I've got space for photographs or journaling or for whatever I want. And of course it is sealed into my envelope. So I am now on my last page. Okay, so... doing that. So this is 5 inches by, it's about 6 3/8, because when I cut the 6.5 and when I tried it against the envelope, it was just a bit too long. So this is just going to be straightforward covering the back page, and then we're going to build on it. Okay. So first thing I'm going to... So this is my last page. It's a 12 by 12 piece of crumb cake, and I've scored and folded it at 4 inches along one side and then 6 inches. So I've got 6 pieces all together. I'm going to take my scissors and I am going to cut up as far as that first place where the joins cross, and now I'm going to go across. Okay, so now I've got that shape, so now I can refold this so that it looks like that, and this side. Is going to be stuck into my book. Okay. Now, if you don't have 12 by 12, if you go over to my blog, I will do a cutting and folding diagram that shows you what size card to cut and where to join it. Okay, but if you've got 12 by 12, it is so much easier because you get this lovely effect. Pulls out just like that. There is my final page with all the mats in place, so I'm just going to open it up and there we go. And as you can see, I've got plenty of space there to add my photos or my journaling or whatever I want to do. I've just finished off the back cover with a little bit of a die cut, which I've held down with a couple of stamped and cut out images, and I could stick a tag into there if I wanted to. And I've just finished decorating off the cover. I've got some, these are moulded from self-hardening clay. I can't think today. So I've got some molds, and I just molded up a whole heap of these and then just painted them and put a little bit of mica powder on the top so that they were shiny. And the same thing over here, a little bit of plastic beads and a little embellishment. And that is it. I am finally finished. It took me a lot longer than I was planning. I think it'll be a while before I do another one of these. And if I do, you know, you learn lessons as you go along. A couple of things that I would do differently. To begin with, I would probably not make it in this size, because as I was trying to add my photographs, and I stopped kind of putting them in because it was getting a little bit tedious for you. As I was adding them in, I realised that I was very much limited to portrait style, unless I wanted to be kind of turning the thing around and doing all of those kind of things. So I would probably make another one. If I make another one, it would either be 6x6 or 8x8. But the whole idea, my whole thought process when I started this off, was to try and use some of the techniques that I use in card making to make you know, to make a scrapbook or a little mini album. So some of the things like the waterfall card, which I was just playing with it, or this one, which is one of my favourite mechanisms ever. I grab hold of it, which is the hidden slider. I absolutely love that because I think that is just so clever. I wish I'd been the person to invented it, but I wasn't. And I created all of these little hidden secret spaces and lots of real estate to put your photographs, and my little sliding octopus, which I really love. So thank you, Carolyn Helvey, for coming up with that mechanism. And lots of spaces to put, you know, tags and, I don't know, little, you know, you could put tickets, souvenirs, mementos in there. So, yeah, so there it is. And if you've stayed with me from the very beginning, thank you very, very much. I do appreciate your patience. If you've just come in on this particular episode and you're thinking, do you know what? Some of those pages looked interesting. I'd like to go and have a look at it. They're all in a playlist. Okay, so I will put the playlist off to one side somewhere. I'll put a link there. You can just go to the playlist and you can go from the very start, which was back in the summer of 2018. And I'm just getting this finished and completed just before 2018 comes to an end. So, again, thank you very much for your patience. Thank you for joining me. Come back and see me sometime again soon, won't you? But for now, bye-bye.